Hi everybody, it's me. It is what time is it? It is 6:52. NCIS is gonna be on 8 minutes. I'm just gonna talk to you guys through NCIS, and I might just turn the camera around and show you clips. So I'll probably be turning the phone around and just show you little clips of tonight's episode. It's going to be called, let me see. Each episode, if you're familiar, what is it called? Exit shortly? No, extra. What is it called? Exit strategy. It's gonna call it exit strategy. That's the episode's name. So yeah. Wheel of Fortune is on right now. One second. I'm trying to exit. Out of this, there we go. Alright, well, I'm gonna try to go and I will get back on here when it gets started. So it's NCIS night, Tuesday. Alright, bye. See you in a little bit, bye.
Torres. 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 Torres.
Yeah.
Check it out. Looks like a normal belt. It's actually a knife. How about this comb? It's like a regular comb. It's actually a knife. I never go anywhere without it, so if there's trouble, I got your back. Got an ink pen. Huh? Looks like a normal ink pen.
Is that a knife?
It's a hidden camera.
Why?
I'm a gadget guy.
No, why are you still talking?
I'm an anxious talker.
Oh, okay, so you were anxious all night? Because you talked all night.
Clearly, you are not willing to participate in this partnership.
We're not partners.
Okay, this is Metro Detective Miles Higgins on a joint stakeout with NCIS Special Agent Nick Torres. We are here to arrest a Vernon Douglas on a dual count of drug trafficking. So far, he's a no-show, but we are going to wait as long as it takes because we're partners.
Right, Nick?
Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah, can I borrow this?
Hey!
It's not just a pen, look at that, it's a frisbee! I gotta make a phone call.
Hey, McGee, you gotta take over for me, man. This guy's driving me crazy.
So why would I want to take over?
But you love him.
Nick, I really think you two should try to work things out.
Hold on, McGee.
Gotta go.
Higgins, our boy just pulled into the south side alley. Hit me around the back.
Where the hell are you? Higgins!
Higgins! Yeah, I thought you had my back.
Hi everybody. I hope you if you watch NCIS, you're enjoying this little bits of clips. Seeing how you guys been. How was your day? I worked from 11 to 5. Then I just bought a salad from work, had that for dinner. Now I'm home. Freddy's barking at something. Watching NCIS. We're probably gonna see a few more clips about 2 minutes long, maybe a minute long. And then I'm gonna turn the camera back around me and do a commercial break and see how you guys are doing. So yeah. Alright, well, I'm gonna let you guys go. It's about to be back on, so yeah. I'm bored. I don't know what to say right now. So alright, see you in a little bit. I'm gonna turn the camera back, I'm gonna edit just run it now, I can't talk. I'm gonna move the videos around on my phone so I have more storage and I will get back to you in a little bit. Bye.
Anything on Lane's SUV?
Nothing to ID or cop killer.
No, but the car itself was registered to a Jessica Potter from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
Oh, and her laptop was hidden underneath the seat. Enemy just cracked the hard drive and sent a link.
That mother looks familiar.
Michelle Lane and Jessica Potter are the same person.
Living under an alias.
And she married Craig Potter from L.A. They have a son, Landon, who's 9 years old. She started a whole new life.
What's she doing back at D.C.?
Yeah, well, they're all partners, dead body.
It has something to do with a 2007 case. She used Tegan's login to look at old police files, specifically the arms dealer she was trying to bust, Benjamin Satano.
Except he died 2 years ago.
Well, somebody had to inherit the family business.
Well, they did. His son, Benny Jr. He's supposedly gone legit by starting a check cashing franchise called Checking Cash for You.
Super legit.
The last webpage Lane visited was the address of Benny's corporate office.
Bishop, Tori, let's go.
Boss, you want me to update Sportelli?
I what?
So you think this woman's coming here to hurt me?
Oh, we don't know that yet.
Well, I appreciate the concern, and that's why I have Nitro, who also makes a mean espresso, by the way, if either of you are interested.
Yeah, so take one of those.
Sure.
Nitro?
Sure thing, Vic.
Please. And Nitro and I go way
back. All right, commercial break number 3. Obviously, that little boy, Landon, has been kidnapped. You know, NCIS is going to get him back. I have no life. So what else did I do today? What else I want to talk about today while I'm commercial breaks? I don't know. I just don't know what to talk about today. Freddy, what you doing? Freddy! Freddy! Hi, Bubbas! Hi, Bubbas! Freddy! What are you doing? Freddy! What are you doing? What are you doing? Freddy, leave him alone. Leave Jasper alone. He's got Halloween decorations up in that window. That's my life with these boys. Bulls on tonight. Same with NCIS New Orleans and Criminal Minds and SVU Law and Order. SVU is on tomorrow. But I might be walking doing those since I'm going to make my meatloaf and green bean casserole. Fish are doing good. What else? I don't know what to say. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. I want more subscribers. I went up to like 30 subscribers this month. 31 this month. And, I'm down to 17. So, and I do have my fan page, Christina Hopeful Boys. And you can follow me on my Twitter feed. I think it's gonna come back, so I'm gonna have to let you guys go. Oh, I can't wait to watch a SWAT show with Shamomo. I can't wait to watch that. I don't know. Alright, well, I'm gonna let you guys go. I'm gonna turn the camera around again and film a 2 minute clip. Oh, it's commercial still. I don't know. Alright, well, I don't have nothing to say during this commercial break. So I'm gonna let you guys go. Bye.
The only recorded reference of such a case appears to be in my notes.
Isn't that a shame? So, save for your lecture, the world would never have such a valuable resource.
The other shoe drops. I knew it. You are here to sell me on a teaching position.
John Jay is the world's premier college of criminal justice.
Spoken while standing in the halls of our alma mater. And you have quite a nerve.
Besides, you're wrong. It's not a full-time position. Just a residency for a semester.
Which I must refuse.
While you write your book. Everything you've seen and done, medical and otherwise. We both know your personal experiences are invariably tied to your medical knowledge. It's the ducky charm.
Flattery will get you nowhere.
I haven't even started. Because I think it wouldn't just be your book. It could be the book. A definitive reference for the entire field. Your story will inspire and empower generations to come.
I have responsibility.
It's a semester in New York. You can even stay with me if you like. I do live alone. How many times have you talked to him since you've been away?
I always call him once a day when I travel, sometimes more.
Have you? On this trip? Well.
Busting my ass to get away from that life. Why would I kill a cop?
Same reason you kidnap Brandon.
What? I mean, kidnap anyone.
It's not just anyone.
Son. Michelle told us.
Michelle. She's here.
She didn't just find out she was pregnant. You two had an affair while she was undercover. That's why she ran away.
Couldn't return to Metro. Everyone can come back for 9 months. Word would have spread to the Sedona family.
You found out that she was still alive, so you blackmailed her. And you took her son, your son.
Heir to the family.
Exactly why I let them go.
So you did find out?
Yes. That was 9 years ago. All right? Why don't you see the baby?
Oh, well. Are you? All right.
Michelle and I had a relationship. After the explosion, I was devastated.
But in my father's line of work, until you see a body, nobody.
It is commercial break number four. I guess Ducky is having a book coming out, writing a book or something. So, I don't know, and this phone has been driving me nuts all day today. Like, my YouTube video from yesterday took forever downloading. And the charger I took to work was crappy, so it didn't charge. And now, the storage is filling up while I make this video as we speak. And when I go move the videos to my Sims card, I have to turn it off, the phone off, turn it back on, so they move. This phone is just driving me nuts all day today. Do you guys have this problem with your phone? Or do I just have a crappy phone? I probably just have a crappy phone because it was cheap. I have no iPhone or anything like that. I wish I had an iPhone, but I didn't have the money to buy the iPhone from Straight Talk at the time, and I didn't get it, and I just don't want a new phone. I don't want to download all those apps. I just don't want to mess with a new phone. I hate messing with new phones. So yeah, he's just so irritating. And look, Freddy's sitting there. Freddy, he annoyed me during the first clip, the clip in front of this, because he wanted to bark. Gosh, he just barks so much. Don't you, Freddy? You bark all the time. Gosh, I never had a dog that barked as much as this beast. So yeah, my phone's probably going to be cutting me off. And so yeah, it's almost over. I think this is it. My next clip is going to be it. So yeah. I have no life. He's getting ready to bark again. You can hear him growling. What else am I going to talk about today? I don't know.
Waterford's new thermal comfort systems use the clean, renewable energy found in your own backyard, saving homeowners up to
I don't know. I'm not going to be able to keep up with this vlog every day, the only Vlogtober up. I don't know what to say every day, or what to do every day. Alright, well, I'm probably going to end this part of this video up. What is Freddy doing? He's like a cat. Look at him. Freddy. Hey. He's like a cat. He's like a dog. God dog. He's crazy. I didn't have any exciting things to say today. Alright, well, see you later, and another clip is coming up. Bye.
That place closed 2 years ago.
Well, Sportelli still pays property taxes. I mean, he's still got a key. Let's go.
Time is precious, Michelle. For all three of us.
I told you, I don't have the funds. I never did. What happened to you, Danny?
Me? What happened to me? I'm insane. Same job, same life, just trying to make ends meet. You, on the other hand.
I made a choice.
Yeah, here's another one. You went to Higgins and forced my hand. And now I'm going to force yours. The money or your son? Just tell me when you stash the bearer bonds and I'll disappear just like you. Please!
Offshore camp, Cayman Islands.
Account number?
choice. Wait, so it was a lie? Lane didn't have an offshore account?
No, she was stalling.
Where's the $2 million?
I have no idea. Could still be at the bottom of that marina.
And McGee?
Hi guys, that was the end of Insania. I hope you enjoyed it.
And only 50 calories.
I have the camo tendering on. Can you see me? Yeah. I have the camo turn it around. I cannot see this flash. Turn it around. I'm going to show you guys the preview. The next episode, I hope you enjoyed watching NCIS with me. I hope you enjoyed watching NCIS. I hope you enjoyed this video, even though how kind of it was kind of lame and boring. I'm going to call it a night. I had nothing to say. I'm just waiting for the preview to come back on. That's it. I'm just waiting for the preview to come on so you can see it. So yeah. I'm so bored and it's cold. Meatloaf is tomorrow. I can't wait to make meatloaf. Gosh, I have no life. I know what to say.
Some pants. Five in pieces following mom. A night of premieres.
Hold on.
Welcome to your new home, Agent. Maria Bellotti. takes NCIS.
I answer to Director Betts, not to you.
Fine, Storm. But this case is not about to blow over.
I don't like games.
You like having your own boys, but could you enjoy a good fight?
New NCIS, CBS next Tuesday, or stream it live or on demand.
Alright, well, that looks like it's going to be a good episode next week. Alright, well, I'm going to call it a night, because I have no life. Alright, well, bye, see you tomorrow, meatloaf, and keep green bean casserole, bye.